we're back with our Google Contacts tutorial about how to use Gmail to dominate your data. If you didn't watch part 1, you're missing out! Follow the link in the description and check it out. There are loads of Google Contacts and Gmail tips that you probably didn't even know about. Now, NetHunt Gmail CRM here, productivity expert and professional learning hub. Today we're looking at leveling up your Google Contacts database to give you an edge on your competitors. Next up, we're looking at importing your existing data. If you're moving from a spreadsheet, great! You're moving all your data from one blatantly unproductive place to a supremely productive place. When you've got all your data in Contacts, you're going to be able to do so much more. Head to Google Contacts, select the Import button. An upload window will pop up asking you to import a CSV or vCard file previously exported from other software. Before you import your contacts, you can set a label. But bear in mind that you can only import 3,000 contacts at a time. If you've got more, just split up your contacts sheets. The next natural step in our whirlwind Google Contacts adventure is how to export from Google Contacts. Maybe you've got a snazzy new CRM system and you want to take it for a spin? Maybe that CRM system is NetHunt CRM, where you can export your Google Contacts too and start taking advantage of the bulk email and pipeline management features to give your customer base a really informed customer experience. There's a link to a 14-day free trial in the description. You might as well give it a shot. Exporting is easy. You've just got a few different file types to choose from. The Outlook CSV format exports all data and converts names to the default character encoding. Just open up your contacts, hit Export, select your file format, and get exporting. All you need to do after that is save your new exported file. Here's a little something you should know about the different types of files you can export in Contacts. Google CSV allows you to import your contacts into another Gmail account. Outlook CSV allows you to import your contacts into Microsoft Outlook. vCard format, this allows you to import your contacts to Apple Address Book, OS X Mail, or any other application. For all of the contact filling techniques we've talked about, Google Sync automatically does the rest to have your contacts in Gmail as well. Your prospects are ready to be reached out to. Talking of automatic, you can sync your Google Contacts with NetHunt. Just head to the Settings section of your NetHunt dashboard and Google Contacts Sync. You turn Sync off or on here. When on, NetHunt runs a regular sync every day to keep all your data fresh. The productive cherry on the Google Contacts cake is Labels, Google's name for groups in Contacts. But how to create groups for Google Contacts? Labels are the most helpful CRM feature in Google Contacts. You can assign each individual contact a label and group them together. From there, you can fire out red-hot email campaigns, engage your clientele, and secure the deal. Labels are easy. Just head to the Add or Edit Contact screen and you'll find it right at the top next to Add or Edit Contact. To see all your grouped contacts, simply click on it. If you want to send out a bulk email campaign to them, all you need to do is start typing the name into the section of Gmail and autofill will pop up. NetHunt's Google Contact Sync lets you sync either all your contacts or specific labels within contacts. Afterwards, you can take advantage of NetHunt's powerful bulk emailing features, including mail merge, templates, unlimited sending, and email tracking. It's easy! Simply head to the Email Campaign tab, click New, name your campaign, and choose which folder you want your recipients to come from. If you want, you can also use filters to segment and send your campaign to, like this. Make sure there are no duplicates, hit Continue, and head to the Template Editor. Time to write your message. I'm going to write something nice for our current users with low account activity. Okay. Here's my subject, here's my body of the email, and that's all we wanted to say. Add some macros, preview whether these macros have worked. Obviously, I need to check my spelling too, and then it's time to send a test. The test email lands in your inbox and tells you exactly what the email will look like for recipients. Finally, you can send your campaign, wait a little bit, and track who has opened and clicked through with the email tracking feature. Your Google contacts are looking fabulous, and now you've got all your contacts in Gmail as well. You're gonna wanna share that with the world at some point. Sharing contacts is another vital tool to make your business more productive. You need to know how to share Google contacts. There are a few things to consider when you're sharing. The directory administrator has to enable contact sharing. Contacts can be shared only with people of the same domain as you. You and your team must use a PC or a laptop to access the delegated contacts, not a phone or a tablet. So, make sure that you're signed into the Contacts Manager with your work or school account. At the top left, click Settings, Delegate Access. Click Invite Delegate. Enter the name or address of the person you want to give permission to manage your contacts and click Send. Similarly, in NetHunt, you can delegate different access to different users. Contacts are usually viewable in the NetHunt dashboard to anybody you grant access to. There's no need to send and resend contacts all over the place. Everything in one place, that's what NetHunt's about. Your data is your business. The sooner you get on top of it, the sooner you get to the top of your business. Google Contacts is an ingenious free productivity tool to help you do that. Got any more G Suite productivity secrets you think people should know about? Let us know in the comments below. After that, check out our video on how to use Gmail CRM to grow your business. You do want to grow your business, right? Like, comment, and subscribe. NetHunt over and out.